What is a sacred place? What makes it feel sacred? Is it the spirit connecting with something extraordinary? Powerful? Nameless? Why are we drawn to these places? Does sacredness occur because it touches us in ways we can't describe, and yet know are real? Does the sacred place comfort us, heal us? Does it challenge us as it pushes against our senses? Is it a place in which, by simply being there, we are changed? Our breath, our heartbeat, our thoughts, ourselves. What is a sacred place? What happens when the mind meets natural shape, form, color, and light? Is it wonder? These places come from forces we can only pretend to know. Is it inspiration? From the dawn of our species, we have sought to mimic the infinite variety of color and texture, with paintings on cave walls to canvas, with grand architecture, with exotic patterns woven into fabric. We create to echo creation. From the dawn of our species, we have sought to mimic the infinite variety of color and texture. We create to echo creation. There is an exquisite beauty to life thriving in adverse circumstances. In the harshest of environments, it refuses to yield. It uses whatever clever and extreme measures necessary to exist. To flourish, no matter what. And in that ultimate challenge, each tiny success is a marvel. Proof that mediocrity does not exist in nature. Thank you. water, constantly in motion. Rising, falling, freezing, melting, shifting shape by the moment. It is life. It persists. All the water here at the dawn of time is still here, trapped by the pull of this spinning stone. This water planet. It is life. Great mountain ranges reduced to their smallest parts. Waterless oceans of sand. Wave upon wave. Yet there are more atoms in one human body than there are grains of sand in all the dunes and beaches of the world. These particles are constantly moving from one form of matter to another. It is possible that each of us will have atoms in our body from nearly every other being that has ever lived. We are quite literally a part of each other, and everything is a part of us. Everything is a part of us. In the beginning, there was only one element in the universe. Hydrogen. It coalesced into vast pools of the perfect, violent fuel. And as the stars burned like an unimaginable crucible, helium was born. It was only when these lonely two experienced a star supernova of self-destruction that all the rest of the elements were created. Earth and sky, us, from the dust of stars that once were. Thank you. dust of stars that once were. What is this yearning for spiritual experience? To touch that which is sacred. The desire informs our history across cultures and geography. We sense there is something greater than our intellect. Yet the intellect cannot know it, touch it, feel it. It seems the only way to come in contact with it is to perceive without the noise of the intellect. Like the infinite universe itself, it is unknowable, yet there. what is truly sacred.